Hi everybody, it's Red Hill Eagle here, and welcome back to my channel. This is something very different, although not completely different. I have, in the past, done this. I've played Ironsworn Starforged, which is what I'm going to be doing now as well, a new series. I've also kind of tried the RPG route with Star Trek Adventures. Didn't quite work out. I didn't get on with it, to be honest. Probably need to read the book again, and I don't know, but to be honest, Starforged is just, I think it's a great game and I'm willing to give it another go. I still very new to role-playing games. I don't really play at all. I dabbled a little bit, but still really my experience is zero. I mean, I do have two very short-lived series with Starforged, which you can find. I'll probably link them as well. But they were very, very short-lived. So yeah, I'm going to give it another go in front of an audience. This initial episode, though, is literally just going to be what we know as our session zero. I do already have, though, my character, and I've already set my truths. So we're just going to kind of go through those, really. So I'll sort of take you through my character first off. He's known as Captain Sky, and his call sign is just Captain. Pronouns are he, him. Momentum starts at 2, as we know, health 5, spirit 5, supply 5. I've gone with the, in inverted commas, easy route with regards to skills. Trust me, it's not that much easier. But edge 4, heart 2, iron 3, shadow 2, and wits 3. My starship is known as the Anvil. And I am, the other assets I have, I've got two paths and a companion. I give myself Weapon Master, so I will be pretty handy with most kinds of weapons that I come across. I might, for to create some peril sake, there may be occasions where I come across a weapon I don't know how to use it. But generally, most weapons I come across, I'll be able to use them. In-game, when I enter the fray, I can add +1, and I take +1 momentum on a hit. Once per fight, when I gain control by switching weapons or changing tactics, I can take an automatic strong hit. Down here, bottom left, I've also given myself Scavenger. I kind of like the idea of being kind of like a lone, I don't know what you'd call it really, a lone adventurer who's just kind of scavenging to survive, really. I have sort of thought of a little bit of a background for my character. We'll get there in a minute, but yeah, I like the idea that I'm kind of doing what I can to survive and make money. You know, I'll do any job, you know, as long as you're going to pay me, I'll do it. But generally, I go into kind of wrecks and stuff, and I salvage what I can and sell it. So mechanically, in game, when I gather information or resupply by scavenging a wreck, ruin, or abandoned site, add +1 and take +1 momentum on a hit. On a strong hit with a match, I also find something of unique value, significance, or function. Envision the nature of the discovery, take +2 momentum, and mark 2 ticks on your discovery's legacy track. Okay, my companion, I'll give myself a utility bot, so something that can kind of hack into sites for me or fix things. You know, just kind of handy, like a handyman, but a droid. Basically, I'm kind of thinking or imagining a kind of smaller version of like a floating R2-D2 kind of thing. I mean, there's probably a Star Wars character that I could better imagine, but I'm not a great Star Wars fan, so I can't think of anything at the moment. But yeah, some sort of like floating droid that's got like arms and different tools and stuff that they can use. So mechanically, again, we'll go through it. When I make a move by directing Buddy, my utility bot, to access a system, cut through an obstacle, analyze a mechanical issue, or assemble or disassemble a device, roll plus its health, and take +1 momentum on a hit. On a strong hit with a match, it reveals an unexpected advantage or insight, take another +1 momentum. Okay, so my challenges at the moment, I have just got my background vow, and this just kind of came to me, really. It came to me probably a few weeks ago before I even decided to do this, about I must have seen something that sparked the inspiration, but I was on some sort of ship. We'll for now call it a colony ship, and maybe I was surveying for a potential planet for us to build a new colony, for humanity to build a new colony. And whilst I was there, perhaps with a small team of other surveyors, something happened. We don't know what. We don't know what. But the ship just decided to leave without us. Just decided to leave. We don't know why. That is my background, Val, to find out what happened to this ship, which I have named the Alexandra. So we, or myself, I want to find out what happened that day to the Alexandra. Why did it just rush off? Is it still alive? Is it still around? Is it still in one piece? Are the people that were on the ship still alive? That's my background, Val, and I will set that obviously to epic. I don't have anything else at the moment because we haven't got anything else. Campaign. For the moment, I've just called it Adventure One because I've got a name for it. We'll go through our truths in a minute. I've chosen them rather than rolled on them because I kind of have an idea of how I want things to kind of pan out. Sector. I haven't really done. I've just created one planet. Whether that'll actually become a thing when I start properly, I don't know. I just created one as a tester, really, I guess. I'm using the. I should have mentioned at the beginning. I'm using the Stargazer app for Ironsworn Starforge, which is just it's just brilliant. There's lots of other great tools out there, but I just find I just really like this one. It kind of works for me. Right, so yeah, let's go through my truths. I'm not going to read out the entire the paragraph that each of these has, but it's a basic rundown of what is true within our universe. Okay, so the reason we left the Milky Way, the reason we left our original galaxy, interdimensional entities invaded our reality. So we were invaded by something. We already had, perhaps we already had interstellar travel. We could travel to the outskirts of the Milky Way. Then we were attacked. The entire galaxy was attacked. We fled. We fled on a ragtag fleet of ships propelled at tremendous speeds by experimental faster-than-light drives. Those ships carried our ancestors to the Forge, and that's where we are now. We are several, perhaps hundreds, maybe thousands of years after all this, so we're kind of established, and that's where the next truth comes in. We have made our mark in this galaxy. We don't have territory over the entire galaxy. There's still a lot to be discovered. It's massive. But we have a foothold. We've made our mark. People know that we're around. We have met other races. There will be other races in this game. Yeah, so there's that. There are different factions and stuff now. There are different groups of people. I don't want to use the word nations, but people, obviously, people who live on a certain planet identify themselves as being from that planet. And yeah, so we've made our mark. Our iron vows, or our vows, are sworn upon the remnants of ships that carried our people to the Forge. It's more kind of like it's an old tradition rather than something we actually do. Because we're several hundred, if not thousands of years now since humanity arrived at the Forge, a lot of these remnants of the ships don't exist anymore, or they're old, they're worn out, they're whatever. But it's more of a, we say we swear upon the remnants of the ships that brought our ancestors, but we don't necessarily have a physical piece of iron that we swear that on. We did initially, we did have those pieces of iron, and some people still do. Some people who perhaps traditionalists or just people who are lucky enough to still have something like a family heirloom or something that's part of a ship. Maybe we can still they can still be found out there somewhere in places, whatever. Laws and governance, they vary across settled domains. So they vary between star system to star system. Within those star systems, they can vary from territory to territory, planet to planet. It all depends where you are. It really depends on how structured the governance is and the laws are. So there are going to be places that are very strict and structured and organized, and there are places which are basically just going to be a free-for-all. Religion. Our faith is diverse, is as diverse as our people. So faith will exist. There's quite a lot of different religions, but I want to say that it's not a big thing. There are people who are religious. There are people who are attached to certain religions, but it's actually quite, I don't want to say rare, but not many people practice anymore. But it's not completely unknown. So if you come across someone who's praying or doing some kind of religious ritual, you're not shocked by it, but it's just something that you don't see very often. Okay. Magic. Magic doesn't exist. So we can't use the force or anything like that. There are obviously people who can use sleight of hand. There are people who can produce trickery and, you know, tricks on your eyes, that sort of thing. But as far as kind of pulling a rabbit out of a hat, doesn't exist. Communications. So most settlements have well-developed networks, and there are various hubs scattered around the galaxy, and maybe there is a group of people, or there's a whole industry out there where we are still, you know, putting hubs out there. The further we delve into this galaxy, that, you know, we put down these hubs to future-proof our network. So some settlements will have, you know, instantaneous kind of internet, perhaps even some star systems, some territories, you know, you might be able to get information instantaneously between star systems, but then other areas won't have any at all. It'll be, you know, be difficult, be very hard. So, you know, very kind of diverse, and it's all going to depend where I want to go narratively. If I want to create an issue where communications is an issue, then I'll put it into the narrative that we are in a place at the moment where the internet just doesn't exist, or there is no communications kind of hubs here, you know, whatever. We're still using carrier pigeons, you know. But then there are other places where we can get information quite quickly. Okay, so medical. Orders of sworn healers preserve our medical knowledge and train new generations of caregivers. So I don't want a situation where there's a hospital around every single corner. Okay, I'm in peril. I've damaged my arm, my leg, whatever, and oh, that's right, there's a, you know, 2 miles away, I can just, you know, get it fixed. There are hospitals. So again, there are some better than others. It depends what star system you're in. It depends what planet you're on. It depends what landmass or country you're in on that planet. You know, everything's going to be quite as it is in real life on Earth. Some places are more developed than others. Some places have more resources than others. It's all going to depend on the narrative. Artificial consciousness. So this is AI. Artificial consciousness emerged in the time before the Exodus, and sentient machines live with us here in the Forge. So yeah, I want AI to exist. I want droids to be quite a big thing, actually, in this galaxy. I think most of my battles, most of my combat will be against droids of some sort. I am very conscious of death in games and TV and movies. And I know very much a lot of TV shows, particularly science fiction TV shows, they try to shy away from killing. It has to be a thing, but I would rather the majority of my kills be against, you know, artificial intelligence, droids, rather than an actual human or, you know, sentient being, if that kind of makes sense. There will be, or there probably will be, some here or there in maybe extreme circumstances, and perhaps to tell a particular story or to evoke some kind of emotion, but we'll kind of get there when we get there. War never ends. Okay, I don't want there to be a massive intergalactic war that we're right in the middle of, but the galaxy is a big place. We have made our mark. Somewhere, there's always going to be some kind of war. There may be several wars in the background that I'm aware of, and I may get involved in every now and then, or I may have to get close to. I've been given a job to deliver something, and it happens to be right in the middle of this territory that's at war with this other, you know, maybe. But I'm not specifically in a ongoing war. But I think it makes sense to have wars. They do exist. Maybe some are small, maybe some are big, but there's not kind of one ongoing, you know, Rebel Alliance versus the Empire. No. There may be that somewhere going on, but it's not at the centre of our story. It's not the centre of my character's story. This is a perilous and often inhospitable galaxy, but life finds a way. Yep, so I want lots of life. I want lots of different races. When I say lots, I'm not going to sort of create a different race every 5 minutes, and we'll have lots of recurring races, and there'll be kind of, maybe we're the, I don't want to say dominant race, but maybe we're the highest percentage of, you know, there's more humans in the Forge than other races, but, you know, there's an awful lot of other races, and yeah, we'll kind of create them as we come across them. I might create one or two just as a starter before our first adventure, but yeah, there's lots of life out here. Over eons, a vast number of civilizations rose and fell within the Forge. So, yep, we've been here hundreds, if not thousands of years, but over the millennia and over the eons, there have been previous civilizations and empires that have risen and now fallen in the Forge. I mean, we're talking this galaxy is millions of years old. So, perhaps billions, probably billions, actually. So, we will come across evidence of that. There's certainly scope for archaeology and exploration of, I'm trying to find the right words. There's scope to explore remnants of some of these previous civilizations. Some maybe not all of them have been discovered yet. Maybe we will discover one of them. Who knows? Okay, horrors. Most insist that horrors aren't real. Spacers know the truth. So, there's no scientific evidence that ghosts are real. There's no scientific evidence that the dead can come back as zombies. But people have seen things. So, yeah. There might be a little bit of that in some of the stories I tell, but I'll try and always leave it kind of open-ended as to, well, maybe I didn't see what I thought I saw, maybe there's a scientific explanation, but maybe not. Okay, so that's the truths. I've been recording for nearly 20 minutes now. I didn't want the first one to go on too much because this is literally just to kind of get the ball rolling and show you guys what how I intend to play. So I'm going to go away and have a think. I'll probably roll up a couple of planets here and there, and maybe a couple of races, and we'll just kind of go from there. I'll think up some kind of quest for the first adventure, or, hey, even better, you guys give me one. You guys give me an idea. Tell me what my first adventure should be. So I'm alone in my ship with my utility bot. I'm looking for something that's going to earn me some money, or some brownie points with a faction of some kind. You know, I've kind of got a couple of little ideas, but yeah, let's see what you guys have got. Give me something. So please like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this. I will be back soon with the next adventure. I can't promise when. I do a few other things on my YouTube channel, and yeah, so my schedule, we'll see how it goes. I don't want to leave it too long though, so come back and see the next episode. Hope you've liked this one. Take care of yourselves, everybody, and I'll see you all again soon. Goodbye.